Well, hello everyone. We're back with another show of Helping Hands. And in the community, there are so many people doing good. I wanted to try to bring a show out to help communicate and help the different causes. And today, we have Steve and Erica with us. I appreciate your coming on, by the way.
Thank you.
And
thank you.
Tell us a little bit about yourselves and the restaurant, the name of the restaurant and where you're located, and it'll fill people in on why I really brought you here today.
Well, we have Mom Pop's Country Kitchen. It's on South Park Road, right across from the industrial park. And we bought this business and started in January. It was formerly Jim and Lulu's.
Okay.
The chef that was there, Jim Kearns, did a wonderful job at starting a really good business. His food was wonderful. And we were regulars for years. As soon as we became empty nesters, there was no point after work to go home and try and cook a meal or something, and we would meet there after work. And we have a lot of friends that we've made through the years there that are were also regulars. And so I would say over about a 2-year span, Jim would walk up and down the counter saying, isn't somebody going to buy this place? I think he was venting frustration many times, but nobody really took him seriously. So one day we thought that maybe it would be something for us to look into for real.
Were you surprised when you responded to Jim? And he said, yeah.
Well, it was the beginning of that conversation was actually with me and him. Erica was at work, and he come past me and said, when are you going to buy my diner? And I looked at him, and I put a $100 bill on the counter and said, is this a good deposit? And he sort of pushed it back to me and said, talk to your wife, and if you're serious, come talk to me. And
wow.
I would venture, I don't know, 12, 14 weeks later, we owned the diner.
No kidding.
So it was... something that when the initial conversation happened with Jim, her and I probably spent every night at home talking and the pros and the cons. And
it's a tough business, right?
From what I hear from everybody now, it's like, well, where were you whenever I was trying to make this decision?
Okay.
But it's actually been a great opportunity. After working outside for years. And
what did you do?
Quite a few things. I had my own tree business for almost 25 years.
Okay.
And after I climbed out of a perfectly good set of knees and got some replacements, started running equipment for a sign company and then for a plumbing company here in Bethel Park, ran their excavation department and the last 2 years. And you know, it's something that's always been a passion for me. I did some cooking, I would say about 40 years ago. I spent 2 winters inside with no windows and said I had to get out. Well, then I got out. And probably close to 40 years later, you know, now I want to get in. I'm getting old. My bones are getting cold.
And they're getting wiser.
So,
when our children were young, there was the little restaurant, D-Mars.
Yes.
Remember that?
Yes, I absolutely do.
Okay. Well, in the morning, if I was at work, he would take the kids down for breakfast.
Mm-hmm.
And they loved it.
I would take my kids down for breakfast.
There you go.
Yeah.
And he used to say, you know, throughout the years, it would really be, wouldn't it be neat to have a little diner? And my first job when I was a teenager was in the kitchen of a Holiday Inn.
Okay.
So dishes, short order cook,
you
know, while I was going to nurse's training. So that kind of, you know, we both dabbled just a little and, you know, I guess it gets in your blood.
Yeah, so, I guess it did.
Yeah.
A big part of it, you know, people say, oh, you own a restaurant. Well, no, I own a diner. A diner is different. A diner has personality. It has relationships that have developed into almost a family type Christian love kind of relationship. There's people that initially when we took over would come in and sit at different tables. Well, now they're dining together.
Really?
So it's friendships have evolved, and very good, very close friendships have evolved. But
you don't see that.
That's a big part of it. Yeah. And I remember Father's Day, I was working and we were really busy. Mm-hmm. And there was people sitting, two people were sitting at a table for four. Mm-hmm. And then there was a table for two that came open, but there was four people waiting. And they said, oh, well, you know what, we'll move over here and they can sit here.
Is that right?
Well, that happened like four or five times. And you don't see that at other places.
Right.
I mean, this is a diner. This is more of being at home, mm-hmm. more of a home type atmosphere, you know. Mm-hmm. So it the friendships and the being able to converse with people. How's your family?
Yeah.
You know, how's your son doing? How's your mother who's sick? How's she doing? Is she out of the hospital yet? Yeah. We don't see somebody for a while. It's like, does anybody have their phone number?
Uh-huh.
Can we find
uh-huh.
out if something happened? You know. And you know, unfortunately, there's been a time when something did happen, and mm-hmm. and it touches everybody. And it's amazing how many people can be touched by a stranger, if you would.
Yeah.
These people don't know each other. We even had trouble finding out where this person lived, mm-hmm. but through a hairdresser, we were able to make a connection. You know, and it, as sad as it was still an opportunity for us to show that person that there was love here at the diner for them.
Wow.
But it's connections like that has made us feel at home, as well as we prefer to try to make everybody else feel at home also, and it works.
That's super special.
Yeah, and that camaraderie really was in existence before we bought it.
Mm-hmm.
The staff that worked there were, you know, pretty good friends. Mm. It was like a family.
Yeah,
right.
And whenever Jim was talking about selling it, the thought of it being broken up, you know, by a company that wanted to buy it or
right,
something like
or
that
kind
of made us feel bad, because we really valued our friendships mm-hmm. that we had made there. So, yeah.
Both with the employees. I mean, the employees, there's a lot of connection there,
mm-hmm.
As well as connection with us, because we had been customers there.
Right.
So I've said to a couple of our staff, you know, I want to put your kids through college. I want to help raise your kids. So, you know, we have several employees that have finished college. One young lady's a nurse now, but she still comes back once every 2 weeks and works for us. We have another young lady who has moved on. She's working for Pitt University now. So. But we have one that's in nursing school. We have a couple of professional waitresses.
Yeah.
So that's what they do for a living. They're raising children. They have mm-hmm. one has a family of three. Another one has a single child. We have one that's hoping to be a grandmother. I don't know how much
nice.
She's hoping, but
yeah.
someday, you know. But, you know, God bless her. We have a lot of people there who have developed friendships with Jim and Mary Lou over the years, and as well as, you know, with us. And we didn't want to lose anybody. And that was a big thing to us. We were hoping that nobody was going to jump ship and run away.
And did they?
So,
No.
We had a couple leave, but that was usually because of a reason, you know, one or another that was out of our control. But, you know, graduate college, graduate one actually moved out near the airport, because that's where his mother moved.
Okay.
So he was still in school. But it wasn't because we said, you know what, you know, we don't need you, we don't
right.
want you,
right.
we don't like you. You know, it is. It's a pretty close-knit a group of people.
Now, after you got into the business, because it was only this January of 2018, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
After you got into the business, was it what you expected? How hard is it? And how much have you changed or left things the same? Or what have you done there?
I think that we've tried to make things better.
Okay.
And grow on what Jim had started.
Okay.
You know, with everything, there's a learning curve.
Oh, yeah.
We learned a lot this year.
Well, you started from the ground up.
Yeah. So well, we were
Not quite. Well, the restaurant was established. Yeah. You know, we didn't rent a building. That to me, that's the ground up.
Okay.
But go ahead.
Yeah. So it was just, it was a difficult learning curve at first. A lot of long nights, late nights, you know, trying to both learn what we had to do behind the scenes and learn what the employees were doing in case we needed to step in. We're still trying to learn it all.
But it's a thriving business from what I see as I go by. Right?
They're doing really well.
Now, I understand that you're doing an event for Thanksgiving with your diner. What is that?
When we first started talking about about buying the diner, what were the possibilities? What is it that would this allow it allow us to do? We're members of Ruth Ridd Lutheran Church, and we've worked with the youth group, and we've worked with people doing things for people. This summer camps that they go on fixing things. And so one of our first comments was, well, this would be a great opportunity for us to be able to give back to the community.
When you were even thinking of buying this.
Right, this was before we signed the papers, before we, when we were weighing the pros and the cons. Of course, what did that mean? I shrugged my shoulders and say, I'm not quite sure, but, you know, we there was a firefighter that passed away earlier this year. We raised some money for a family. We helped a gentleman get a furnace after the flood that his had been ruined in the flood. We didn't mention any names. We didn't we didn't want no, oh my God, look what they did for this guy. You know, we didn't do that. You know, we just but this was from the very beginning, what could we do? And Thanksgiving was is an opportunity to serve the community, to be able to open our doors, and with nothing in return guaranteed, we felt that we could serve. Whether you didn't have the money to provide a good Thanksgiving for your family, or whether you just had nowhere to go, your family's halfway across the country. In our case, we have a son in Las Vegas and a son in Buffalo, and may not be able to see them for the holiday. So it gave us the opportunity to, and it's something that we thought about for a long time. You know, you see on TV the Light of Life missions and some of these other places that have the Thanksgiving meals and the Christmas meals. And this was like, this was a golden opportunity. And then was like, well, how are we gonna do it? So I, you know, basically went on the theory, if you build it, they will come.
Well, and as soon as we started talking about this to other people, the ideas were flooding in. And now we have, this is being supported by Gordon Foods, the Bethel Park Rotary, Breadworks, Giant Eagle.
Good for you.
Nappies.
Who else am I leaving anybody out? And our patrons, every once in a while, somebody will give you a little bit of money because they want to
help
in some way.
Yeah.
So it's really been a blessing to us that so many people have wanted this to succeed too. We started a volunteer schedule.
I was just going to ask, how are you going to handle this?
Yeah, so I started a volunteer schedule back in September, and it's full. I mean, we're 3 weeks out, and it's wonderful. The hesitancy now and the concern we have is that we don't have a lot of people who have signed up to come. So we'd like to reach out to the public and make sure that they're aware that this is here for them, and that there's people that they can call to make a reservation for the day.
Okay, so explain to everyone then what exactly this is, who this is for, so everyone listening and everyone watching can think in their minds, I know the right people for that, I'm going to contact you. Mm-hmm. And then I'll ask you for how do they contact you. Mm-hmm. But share with everyone, really, here's who we're looking for, and we don't even know who we're looking for, probably. The people watching and listening really know better than you two, probably. Yeah. But what are you sharing? What are you trying to open this up to?
Well, it's open, first of all, to anyone who may not be able to provide a meal for their family. We understand the food banks and other places are providing Thanksgiving meals, but it was and it wasn't just intended for those who may not have. It's also intended for those who have nowhere to go. There's one of our patrons is actually bringing a blind woman, and she says to me, Steve, she says, you know, I can afford to pay for my meal. And I told her, I said, quite frankly, the register's closed that day. So she knew somebody who had nowhere to go, so she's bringing her. You know, and it's basically if you don't have anywhere to go, any family to visit with, or somebody can, friends that are inviting you over, you know, we're here. We're here for you. We've advertised in the at SHIM, the South Hills Interfaith Ministries, all the churches, and we've put it out to the churches that if you have shut-ins that have that would like to participate, if the church could provide the transportation, because that was something that we felt we weren't able to provide, then we would have we would provide the meals, and then they could provide the transportation of those meals. So it's basically that way. One of the concerns we had were, well, what if we had everybody show up at one time, and with the weather in November, if it was cold and snowy and rainy, what were we going to do? So we decided to come up with a schedule that would be an hour and a half for each setting time, because we can seat 45 people at a time in our diner. So we figured if we do an hour and a half, then that would give ample time to sit and relax and have a meal, have desserts, and enjoy yourself. Get to know the person next to you who might be a total stranger. We also have some musicians from our church coming in, and we have some gentlemen from the Keystone Chorus. They're coming in, and they're going to provide some music for us. So that's, you know, just to sort of make it feel more comfortable and enjoyable. We've got involved with the Rotary since we've been owners, and they have helped volunteer, and they're taking phone calls for us. So you would call in, you would give them your information, they would send you out a reserve time, a reservation card, if you will, and then you know, from there it'd show up. We have some additional parking across the street from our facility, so you know, and as well as in the back lot. So I don't think that's going to be an issue as far as the parking goes or anything like that, but it should really be a great time. It really should. Something to make you feel warm and comfortable and leave with a good meal and desserts.
So it sounds to me, when I'm hearing this, is it's not only necessarily for the quote-unquote needy, it's to try to make a nice Thanksgiving for everyone who might not have a family to spend it with, or for whatever reason.
Whatever reason.
Right?
We don't have a qualification reason. I mean, that's...
Got it.
It's, you know, we're here.
So even if someone wants to come out and just enjoy Thanksgiving with other people, might be...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Now, how do they get in touch with you? And how do they make a reservation or find out more information?
So right now we have Marianne Scott and Bonnie Pierce from the Rotary who are taking phone calls to make a reservation. Do you want me to give those numbers?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Marianne is 412-855-4633 and Bonnie is 412-559-0522. And then my number, it was there to answer any questions or if people wanted to volunteer or drop off cookies or what have you. And my number is 412-670-1212. So really, any of those three, we'd be able to get your reservation.
Okay, and then share everybody again the name of the restaurant, diner, and the address for those listening on the radio.
So it's Ma and Pop's Country Kitchen, 2840 South Park Road, Bethel, 15102.
Okay, that's perfect. Mm-hmm. Now, when you do this event, if it's 45 people, that's maximum capacity, seating capacity, at one time, and you have it set up for an hour and a half, which is very, it sounds very comfortable time frame there, like you were saying. When does it open? When does it close?
Well, we're planning on starting at 10:30 in the morning is our first, and going until 7:30 at night.
Okay.
So mm-hmm. I'm not a mathematician. We're in the 280-ish range. Mm-hmm.
Oh, so you can handle a lot of people spread out over
right,
there.
Right.
I'm cooking for 300 people.
Okay.
So okay. Probably a little more, but, you know, somebody said to me, well, what if you get another 100? Well,
yeah.
I have chicken and hamburgers and pork loin and whatever's in-house I'll be making, but we're planning. I can order enough more supplies if needed if we get that big of a response. We can set up on both ends, you know, okay. add more people on both ends. As long as I know 2 days ahead, I can order more, you know, turkey and have enough of a meal provided. You
okay.
Know, so.
And in addition to the people that are shut-ins, maybe, or that they want to pick up. Mm-hmm. So you're, let me ask you that. Are you allowing people to come by and pick up also, not just the shut-ins that, you know, somebody might be delivering too, but actually people to pick up, or how does that
yes.
work?
Yeah. People can call and say that they'd like to pick up a dinner to go home.
Okay.
And they can are more than welcome to do that.
What do you have planned as what that dinner would be that people are having that day? What do you have a menu set
yeah.
up?
Yeah. So the menu is turkey, and we're making a cranberry chutney that goes with the turkey.
Okay.
Gravy, of course, mashed potatoes, sweet potato casserole.
Stuffing.
Yeah, don't forget the stuffing.
Yeah, forget the stuffing.
Corn and beans, coleslaw, cranberry sauce, separate. Yeah. And then we have pies. Giant Eagle has been very gracious in giving us 32 pies.
Oh my god.
For
goodness.
Thanksgiving. So we'll have pie and cookies, and I think it'll be really
that's
a
very traditional Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
And then if the overflow, like you said, exceeds capacity, you have the other resources that may not be quite as traditional, but
correct.
You'll be fed.
That's right? True. Mm-hmm. Yep. We'll just put a lot of turkey gravy over it.
Turkey gravy over everything is good, I think.
Yeah. Yeah. It's something that you know, initially because it is our first time doing it, especially without having an idea of response, mm-hmm. You know, it is scary, but it's something that if you're going to do it, you have to try to do it mm-hmm. the best you can. And we have a great number of people who are offering their assistance, both food suppliers. Like we went into it not asking for anything. Mm-hmm. We had a whole bunch of people offer monetary donations. Even one of the local banks, PNC Bank, we don't deal with them, and they gave us $200 towards it. So it's some of the local plumber, you know, customers. Yeah. There was a customer from Washington, PA. She's, I don't live in the area. I'm not going to be able to participate. Mm-hmm. I have nobody that I know that would,
right.
but here's $60 or here's $20, mm-hmm. you know, and it's initially I was like, well, no, I don't want it.
Yes.
We don't need it. But we figure, well, we'll take that and we'll use that to help us do it. And
right.
then, you know, if there's anything left over, we can donate to the food bank in other ways, or maybe do something further down the line with Christmas, with children,
okay.
with toys. Foster children. There's always a need for for Toys for Foster Children. That was something that was just brought to our attention.
Okay.
So,
this is in your being, it sounds like.
Yeah.
Not just a standalone event, but rather, from what I'm hearing, a theme of what you're trying to run your lives as, through the diner, helping you out on being able to be a resource for you. Does that sound right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. It's something that, you know, initially, I grew up in a bad neighborhood, so people, I wasn't a very trusting soul, you know. So I'm always thinking of, okay, if they're doing something good, what's from behind?
Yeah.
So whenever people start offering money, I'm like, well, you know, somebody's going to say, well, he's putting that in his pocket.
Yeah.
And that scared me.
Yeah.
So then I started thinking, okay, if there is an overflow of money, what can we do with it?
Mm-hmm.
What other way can we use it? And, of course, kids is my first thing.
Okay.
You know, in working with the youth group with our church,
mm-hmm.
there's always a need. One of our waitresses is raising her grandson. And so there's a foster that put the foster children into my head. You know, people who are adopting children,
yes.
or people who are fostering children, you know, is there a need there? And then talking to her, she has said, yeah, there is, and she could give me some names for that. So,
really?
So it was right away, what can I use if there's an overflow? What can I use it for? So
yeah.
It does. It really opens up many doors.
So this can branch out to helping people that we don't even know yet.
Right.
Correct.
Right.
Right?
Correct.
And
mm-hmm.
purposes.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we want to try to help through this show, help you communicate and get more people involved and get more people to sign up and enjoy Thanksgiving. So is there a way we can get, if anyone wants to contact us, on some churches in the area that hear this, or some any groups or individuals that say, we want a copy of the flyer, we want to try mm-hmm. to get it out to someone. Do you have a resource for that? I can provide one if you don't, but if through the Rotary, you might make that available on a PDF, they might be able
mm-hmm.
to email it out. Is that possible, do you think?
Sure. Absolutely.
Because I can think that a lot of people listening and watching might want to help share our word, which
mm-hmm.
is why we're doing this show. Get the word out. We don't want the resource, which is of you two, to go to waste this Thanksgiving because we've missed some people who would have really enjoyed this. We don't want to make that mistake.
A lot of the local churches have this flyer. Erica went around to a lot of them and already have.
I mailed.
Mailed some of them. Ruth for Lutheran, we handed it to him. One of the pastors, and forgive me, I don't remember the name of the church, and I drive by it probably 10 times a week. It's at the bottom of King School Road at 88.
Okay.
The gentleman is the pastor.
That's
there.
Methodist, I think, over there.
And his wife is a beautiful artist. I know her name, but
okay.
I'm not sure I want to put it out there unless I talk to her first.
That's a good idea.
But we do have a Facebook site, and it is posted on our Facebook.
Oh, good.
We don't have a website,
okay.
but it's on Mom Pop's Country Kitchen Facebook site.
Perfect.
So that all the information
mm-hmm.
is there.
Oh, that's probably a real good resource.
And we have them. We have these flyers right inside our door at the diner.
Okay.
So there's quite a few. If they call the diner, we can even give them the information over
Perfect.
The phone. But that gets a little tricky because when we're busy, it's hard for someone to stop and stand there and give them the information
over the
phone. But
they're posted, yeah. Okay.
But we're hoping that we have posted them in enough places.
Well, I appreciate both of you coming in. We're trying to help. So everyone watching and everyone listening on the radio, please take advantage of this. Share this with your neighbors. Don't think you don't know someone who would benefit from this, because we all probably do. So let's think a little deeper on who might be in need that we're forgetting or overlooking, that's sitting at home alone on Thanksgiving, whether it's neighbors or people we're not thinking about. Dig deeper in your thoughts. Try to think of someone you can help with a very small gesture of just sharing this. And thank you so much, Steve and Erica, for providing this resource. God bless you, and
thank
good
you.
Luck to you.
Thank you, Jack,
for the opportunity.
The opportunity, yeah.